Hi dear students, how are you all? Hope you all are doing good. Children, I'm taking EVS for you. Do you like EVS? Yes, you like EVS. I can see beautiful smiling faces here. Children, without any delay, shall we start our class? Okay, let's begin. Children, you just look around yourself. What are the things you can see there? Tell me. Yes, you can see your table, chair, book, pen, pencils. Then your mother is watching there, no? Yes, your mother, father, brother. Then you have aquarium. Okay, so fishes in the aquarium. Then indoor plants are there. So you can see a lot of things around you. Clear, children? Okay. So children, in this, some of them have life. Isn't it? What do you mean by life? Because they can respond to their surrounding. Teenage children. That is, if you call your mother, she will come and she can move, she can do all the activities. Okay. So, we can say that they all have life. So, which are the things they have life in your surrounding? What? Ah, yes. Very good. Your father, yourself, your mother, then brother, fishes in the aquarium, indoor plants, etc. They have life. So the things that have life are called living things. What we call living things? The things that have life are called living things. And what about table, chair, book, pen, pencil? Are they living? No, they are not living. They have no life, isn't it? Yes. So, the things that do not have life are called non-living things. So, children, today we are going to study about living things and non-living things. Living things. And non-living things. What are living things? The things that have life are called living things, and the things that do not have life are called non-living things. So, dear children, we can see a lot of living things and non-living things around us, isn't it? Yes. To find an object is living or non-living, you just ask three questions. If your answer is yes, then that thing is living. And if your answer is no, then that thing is non-living. What are the questions? Okay, listen carefully. They are, first one, does it grow? Okay, that object will grow. Object grows. Okay, then second question, does it need water? And third one, does it need food? Does it grow? Does it need food? Does it need water? These are the three questions. If your answer is yes, then that thing is living. And if your answer is no, then that is non-living. For example, a plant. First one, a plant need food. Of course, plant need food. Then only it will grow. And second question, a plant grow? Yes, a plant grow. Then, does the plant need water? Of course, a plant needs water. So, we can say that plant is a living thing. A plant is a living thing. Then, another example, a stone. Okay, stone, does it grow? Never, it does not grow. When years pass, it will be same, remain same only. Okay, so it does not grow. Then, does it need water? The stone needs water? No, it does not need water. Then, does it need food? No, it does not need food. So, we can see that the stone is a non-living thing. The stone is a non-living thing and the plant is a living thing. Clear, children? Okay. So, the living thing need food to grow. Food to grow. Air to breathe. And water to drink. These are the three main things that a living thing needs. What are they? Food to grow, air to breathe, and water to drink. Clear, children? Okay. Now just we can see what are the difference between living things and non-living things. How can we say that a thing is living and non-living? How can we differentiate? Okay. First of all, living thing can move. Okay. First thing is living thing can move. For example, we can move from one place to another. Okay, that is we can jump, we can run. Okay, so we can move from one place to another. But if you have a toy, okay, does the toy move itself? No, it can't move. Okay, so a living thing can move thereon, but a non-living thing cannot move. A non-living thing cannot move. Please, children. First point is living thing can move, but a non-living thing cannot move. Okay. Second one, living things can grow. Living things grow. So we know that when we were born, at that time we are very small babies. We have small hands, small legs, very small only. But when the years passed, we increased our size and height. Clear, children? Now you are 7 years old and you have this much height and weight, children. Okay, so after 20 or 30 years, you will become big men and women. Isn't it, children? So we can say that living things grow. But if you have a toy, after 2 or 3 years it will grow? No, it never grow. Clear? So that means it remains same only. So non-living things not grow, but living things can grow. Clear? Next one, living things can feel. What do you mean by feel? For example, when your father brings a favorite toy for you, how do you feel? So you feel very happy, isn't it? Or your mother scolds you, what happened? You may feel very sad. Okay, so this, the feelings, happiness, sadness, then cold, temperature, then touch, these all are feelings. Okay, so if it is very hot, okay, that time we switch on our fan. Okay, so that hotness, that is also one feel. Then touch, then you are cold. These all are our feelings. Okay, so living things can feel. Then we know that we have these feeling, happiness, sadness, everything we have. But do animals have this feeling? Like dog. Yes, they also have, because for example, if you throw one stone to a dog, it will bark at you, you know, children. So they have also feeling. Then I told you plants are also living things, isn't it? Then plants are feeling. Of course, they have also feelings because they are living things now. So they have feeling. You may see that touch me not plant. You may see that. Can you see this picture? Okay, here this is the leaf of touch me not plant. What plant? Touch me not plant. Touch me not plant. Okay, so here the leaves are like this only. If you just touch the leaf of the touch me not plant, it suddenly droop its leaves. Okay, it suddenly droop its leaves. Okay, so this is the feeling of this plant, that is touch me not plant. What is the name of this plant? Touch me not plant. Excuse me. So touch me not plant. Touch me not plant. The leaves are here. So when you just touch the leaf, you can see that suddenly it droop its leaves. Clear? This picture is clear, no, children? You may see this plant around your houses. Okay. Or another example, sunflower. Sunflower, what's the, why we call it a sunflower? Because it always turns face towards the sun. Okay, so it can it has what a response to the sun and the sunflower. So that's a feeling for the sunflower. Okay, so living things can feel, but non-living things cannot. For example, you just throw your toy. Okay, just throw your toy. Is it cry? Never, it will not cry. Why? Because it's a non-living thing. Clear? So non-living things have no, they have no feeling. Okay, have no feeling. Then living things can reproduce. Living things can reproduce. What do you mean by reproduction? The process of giving birth to their babies. Okay, all the living things, they give birth to the babies. Our mother give birth to us, then hen give birth to chicks, then fishes give birth to their babies, then plants from the fruits, we know that seeds, it come from the seed, small saplings are growing. Okay, so all the living things that give birth to the young ones. But if your toy, you take your toy after 2 or 3 years, can the toy produce their baby toys? No, never. Okay, so non-living things can't reproduce. So these are the differences between living things and non-living things. What are the differences? Say with me. Living things can move, living things can grow, they can feel and they can reproduce. Then non-living things can't move, they can't grow, no feeling they have, they can't reproduce their young ones. Clear, children? This is the difference between living things and non-living things. Okay, so now you can easily say that what are the living and non-living things in your houses or in our nature. Okay, then the differences, we know that we studied this. Okay, now non-living things are divided into 2 categories. Okay, non-living things are divided into 2 types. They are natural non-living things and man-made non-living things. Natural means, from the word itself, it is clear that is seen in our nature itself. So what are the non-living things we can see in the nature itself? That means it is not created by human beings. Okay, it is seen in nature itself. What are they? Yes, very good. The sun, moon, stars, mountain, rivers, then air, everything. So these things all are natural non-living things. That is not created by human beings. It is found in the nature itself. Clear, children? Then man-made things means what? It is made by human beings. And you can easily say the examples. What are the examples for man-made non-living things? Yes, very good. Your table, book, chair, pen, pencils, toys, everything. So that is made by human beings. So they are known as man-made non-living things. Clear? So first of all, we studied the objects around us are divided into 2 types. What are they? Living things and non-living things. Okay, living things means what? They have life. Non-living things means what? They have no life. Okay, and living things need food, air and water. Okay, to live, a living thing need food, air and water. Then what are the special differences between living things and non-living things? Living things can move, but non-living things can't. Living things grow, but no growth for non-living things. Living things can feel, but no feeling for non-living things. Living things can reproduce, but non-living things can't reproduce. Then we studied non-living things are again divided into, there are two types of non-living things are there. They are natural non-living things and man-made non-living things. Here, natural means we know that it is found in the nature itself. What are they? Sun, moon, star, rivers, mountains, etc. Then man-made non-living things means what? Your table, chair, book, etc. That is made by human beings. Clear? So this is about today's class. I hope you all understood this class clearly, you know, children. Okay. So in this lesson, we studied four new terms. You can easily say that which are the four new terms? Yes. Living things, non-living things, natural non-living things, and man-made non-living things. So giving a small homework for you, it's not a difficult for you, it's an easy for you. Okay, just observe your surrounding and find out the living and non-living things, and just draw any two living and non-living things, which one you like the most. Draw that picture into your EBS notebook. Clear, children? So did you enjoy this class? Okay. Okay, children, tata, bye bye. See you in the next class.